I can't believe it!
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At 20 bucks a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks. Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure. Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So, did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Ditch class? You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
Let's get the hell out of here.
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Where does this thing go? North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair? Maybe one of these crates. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do?
So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well,
I used to.
Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
I didn't mention it earlier, but you seem to have some kind of Jedi mind powers over Mr. Keaton and the theater crew.
You mean when we were talking about true love in the play? I guess you could say I'm good with people, yeah.
Just don't pull that stuff with me.
You will get on this train.
Oh, shit.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe. Let's do something fun.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu.
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay. Your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. I used to love country music when I was a kid. Now it makes me want to throw up. Literally.
That's weird.
Sad to say this, since you're a Leo and all, but I'm allergic to cats.
Are you now?
Swear. I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade.
No way.
Bitch took my yoo-hoo. Knocked her the fuck out.
I see you like to write notes to yourself.
Helps me stay focused.
Also, sweet scar. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
hella?
Who says that? It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. I'm not sure why country music makes you throw up.
I'm a complex girl, Rachel.
I think it's probably true. Also, I kinda like the Dixie Chicks.
You and David both. No accounting for taste.
Who's David?
He's, the guy my mom's seeing, I guess.
Oh.
And you don't like him. It's still so weird that she's dating someone. My dad and my mom, they were totally in love. You can tell how fucked up she is now just by how she's settling for David. He's this total hard-ass ex-military jagoff type. Like, the opposite of my dad.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. David has no respect. He acts like I'm some kind of problem to solve. Sometimes I am a problem, though.
That's a load of bullshit.
I'm sorry I said anything.
It sounds like the only problem is David. You need to hit him where it hurts.
The only thing that David loves has four wheels and a four-barrel carburetor.
Oh, God. A muscle car?
I'm probably going to steal it soon, so.
Let me know if you need an accomplice. Now, about this broken hand story. It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski out. A bitch takes your yoo-hoo, she's gotta get got.
Damn straight.
But you didn't get that scar from punching someone.
No.
That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
So you're a physician now?
Last summer, I performed a one-woman Doctor Who homage entitled Weeping Angel.
Wait, what?
The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard?
Yeah.
I'd guess 6 years ago?
Seven. Well, shit. I always thought I was a good liar.
Good thing you're pretty. Which brings me to your alleged cat allergy.
Alleged?
I'm calling lie.
Why is that?
I mean, maybe you're allergic. But I've passed by your locker a few times. And I've seen that old photo of a cat you keep in there.
You've passed by my locker? Stalker much?
Hey, I notice things. I can't help it.
I guess you're no stranger to being noticed, too. It's kind of new for me.
Well, get used to it. So, if my math is correct, you cheated. You told one truth and two lies.
Maybe I just needed to test you.
Or maybe you have trust issues.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. Also, you told me about that dickwad David. Now he's on my shit list too.
Hell yeah. Mustache brain won't know what hit him.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
I'm just not really into touchy-feely shit. But I feel like I can trust you.
Yeah?
I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Hey, wanna listen? Bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later. Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks. Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! Fuck it!
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What? Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash. Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe.
I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal? I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck! Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but Apparently, she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that. Score. Here. If you really want to smash something, this should do the trick. I asked you to leave me alone. Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship. But more. Ah. I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something. Chloe, I, you know what? Forget it. This was really stupid. I mean, you're Rachel Amber, and I'm Chloe Price. It's not that. It's just hard right now, and I can't talk about it.
Why not?
Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
You came. I'm glad.
Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed? It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and he was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation. And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? 2 against 1. But you wouldn't take any shit from them.
I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that bottle.
You inspired me. What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
I'm so sorry, Rachel.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.